I'm living in that 21st century, doing something mean to it. Do it better than anybody you ever seen do it. Screams from the haters, got a nice ring to it. I guess every superhero need his theme music.
What is going on, guys? It's your boy Gemini Berserker here, and today I'm going to be doing the Vault of Glass weekly raid with some friends, such as Cosmic and a few other people that you don't know of. Shout out to everyone if you are watching this video that helped. Thank you for participating, everyone, even though there at points we did change raid teams. And just to get it done because people were busy, so I am sorry. But anywho, like I said, today we're going to be doing the Vault of Glass weekly raid, which, if you aren't sure, is the raid of this week. Last week was Crota's End, and I meant to do a video on it, I did, and then my final cut got corrupted, and I lost it. And I honestly did not feel like going back through the hell of doing it again. But I do have the loot, and I can show you guys that in my next video if you like. So, I'm gonna break. So, this video is going to be me breaking down the way the Vault of Glass raid works, everything you need to be aware of, everything, how to do the Templar challenge and Atheon's challenge. So now, without further ado, what's gonna happen is that, so you're gonna get on these plates, which are left, right, and middle. What you're gonna do is stop the Praetorian's Minotaurs from stepping on them, because you have to build that spire that is open, basically the key to that lock, which is the door, which is the opening of the Vault of Glass. Now you have to make sure they don't stand on it, or else it will slow your progression into the raid, and less taking longer than this raid needs to. And honestly, with the challenges and all, if you got a good raid team, as long as everyone's listening and doing what they need to do, this raid should take you no more than a good hour or so. Because usually most raids, such as Crota and Vault of Glass, if you're not speed running, it shouldn't take you more than a good hour and a half. And that's if you're just trying to get the challenges down packed. Now, like I said before, don't let, at this beginning stage, you're not going to want to let those Praetorians take control of those plates, or else it will slow your progress down. Take out as many adds as you can, build your supers before you even get in, as much as you can for the next stage. Now, as you can see here, we're getting ready. The spire should be nearly built or built. You're going to see it says the spire has been formed. And that is when you're going to come up to this gate. You see that gate open. You're going to run into it. As you saw, they were trying to glitch their way into it, which is fine. It doesn't break anything. It's not cheating or nothing. It just helps you get into the vault a little quicker. And you can only really do that once the gate starts to open, I believe. So you're going to make your way down here. As you see, with my spare, I'm just trying to get through there faster because I don't feel like walking. You know, follow these paths. The loadout I chose to go with this, and what I recommend, is usually something that has high impact for your primary, but you want something that can shoot at a moderate rate. So I chose to go with the Talalic Exotic Warlock Scout Rifle. Now, as you see here, we just opened up the first chest, which gave us some ammo synthesis, a few legendary engrams, and those bows of ale. That was that jump was actually going to lead us to a secret chest, which you can follow the path for. I eventually chose not to take that path, so you guys can see the regular way of getting down, so that way you don't always have to take that if you really don't feel like it. So basically, they all went there. They were all just changing their stuff to fix it. I was just like, okay, whatever. Doesn't really matter to me. I'll probably run back through and get it on a different time. Excuse me. So now I'm going to show you the... I tried to get a secondary loot. You can see they're all down there. They were wondering where I was. I was like, eh, you guys can go ahead. So you're going to take, if you want, you can take the regular path down, which is the way I'm showing you. You can still summon your sparrow to get down here faster. Now, you might want to be careful if you're doing that with your sparrow. I almost died, but luckily I jumped off. Now, at this point, they were like, oh, do you still want to try and get it? I was like, you know what? Yeah, I was like, you know what, maybe I can get my way back up. So I did try to. You don't have to, like I said, you don't have to go get this chest every single time. It'll usually just drop like ammunition for your gun, like ammo sense. which aren't bad, and which I would probably recommend before you start any raid, key prime, always, always, always have heavy ammo synthesis on you, or else it is gonna make your life a living hell. Because in raids, heavy, you already guys know if you already play Destiny, heavy ammo doesn't drop like candy. It does not. But to have heavy ammo synthesis on you, as you'll see later in the video, which I have a good number of, because I always stock up when Zer comes by, because you get 3 for 1, and you get a lot more for like 3. Oh, I'm sorry. And you get 10 of them for 3 strange coins, which isn't a bad deal, being those strange coins drop pretty frequently in this game now. So, as you see, I was trying to get back up. I was like, yeah. I did give up, so it's all cool. But like I said, you see they're getting Sublime and Legendary Engrams. Usually it's marks or basically your class item, maybe like a helmet or some boots. Usually some ammo synthesis, but it's, you don't have to, like I said. So, like I said, you're going to make your way down here, because this is going to be the beginning phase for the next section of the Vault of Glass, being the Oracles. Now, once everyone groups up down here, we'll explain how the Oracles work and how not to die up there. I think someone fell off. So I did eventually go back with my Titan and go that way, and I'm just walking them back. So right now, as you can see, I'm using. Now for the Oracles, what I probably would suggest is, if you're not going to be watching out for the hidden ones, which I'll get into all that later, you might want to run a shotgun or a heavy machine gun or a rocket launcher, because they do almost instant damage and can wipe out the Oracles. Now at this point, we're just waiting. I was running the Talalik, the Matador 64, and Swarm, which I felt was a pretty good run for this. So now this is where the Oracle and Templar boss battle will be. So in this first part, you might die here. Honestly, it shouldn't take you more than probably about 20 minutes, not even 15, to do this part, because there are 4 rounds of Oracles. But before that, you have to defend the confluences, which you start off with the middle one, which I passed. All you have to do is just stop the Vex from sacrificing themselves to it, because you see that little thing of light? That is the cleansing pool. The cleansing pool stops the ritual of negation, which will over time kill you. So to prevent that happening, you jump in there, but you can only use it 3 times. So at here, you just really, this is the perfect time for, if you don't have ammo, try and get ammo back, build your supers, all that good stuff. You know, discuss with your teammates who wants to take the left conflux, who's going to take right, who's going to take middle when the time comes, because after these 2 rounds of defending them, you're going to, like I said, you're going to defend them from the Vex, which will, and be careful as well as here, because the fanatics are cursed, basically. And you'll probably, if you saw up there earlier, that pool of green stuff, that is from fanatic residue, as you see here as well. When you kill the fanatics, they die, they leave this green pool of cursedness, I guess, for the ritual. Right there, everyone fucked me over, because I was trying to get orb, get my Nova Bomb back. But yeah, like I said, you can build your super a lot quicker. You use it more frequently, try and build orbs. If someone has armor that is based on orbs, where they get their health back, that's good for them. Or they get melee or super energy back, that's good for them, because then you're being a team player. Now, preferably what you would want to run is, now you see how it says ritual negation. He's preparing to let the fanatics out, which are happening right now. So to stop that, you kill them. Like I said, build supers, get ammo if you need to, devise a plan. Now as you see there, at this point we were running, I believe, 3 Titans, 2 Warlocks, and a Hunter on this attempt that we changed later down the line to, I believe, 4 Titans, and a Warlock and a Hunter. And actually, that's key. You can still stop them from sacrificing themselves, but you have to be pretty good with it. So, like I said, stop them from sacrificing. The second round is the left and right. So you devise a team that will take left. Really, you don't have to. This is like the least stressful part of this raid. It was really funny because we were making jokes the whole time, which is fine. I'm not sure if you guys know Rick Kakis, the Destiny YouTuber, and just the whole time we were like, Rick Kakis here with another exclusive video showing you how to get through the Vault of Glass. And it was just a good time. You know, we had fun. There were a little stressful parts of doing the Templar challenge, but I will get into that at that segment. I also put time indications to where you can jump to each part. I actually probably put that in the very beginning so you don't have to worry about it. But here, the Minotaurs are the biggest threat to the confluences because they will dissolve faster for whatever reason and really take a toll on the confluxes. But as you see here, we have what we chose to do was, well, it just so happens we had three Titans, two Warlocks, and a Hunter. Now at this moment, like I said, you can see how he built the orbs. I'm getting the orb, building my super back. So now the third round, or give it a second, I can't remember off the top of my head of what happened, but usually you might want to bubble with blessing and weapons just to help you out do more damage and help you not die as quickly. As like in the old raids, you could revive teammates for whatever reason, just now that you can't. So be careful when dying. If you're a Warlock, probably for the Vault of Glass, you really don't have to run self-res since everyone's going to be going out to do the challenge modes. And now, as you can see here, the three confluences are now up. So since we were down a man, we had to leave a person with to defend the center confluence, which is least threatening because you can see all your enemies coming, and then people from your left, as you can see here. So that is one thing not to do. It says mark for negation. Now, that pool isn't there, so I was actually in danger. I was like, oh crap, I'm going to die. I don't have self-res because I'm running Voidwalker right now. But it doesn't take place only when he prepares for the ritual of negation. That is when you have to be worried. So I cleanse myself using up one of them, which was as you saw there in the bottom left, it said a Vex had sacrificed itself. Now I'm assuming it was coming from the right side, being as though I didn't see anything on the left like last time where you can see them dissolving. Yeah, see there, as it said ritual of negation, had I still been marked, I would have died instantly. So just one thing you want to avoid when doing this portion of the raid. Now, like I said, you still want to just, even if you guys are just at this point, you want to devise a plan for the Templar challenge. So you can decide who's going to be the relic holder. No, I'm sorry, drawing a blank there.
I'm really sorry.
You want to devise a plan for who will be the relic holder. Now, the relic holder's job is going to be pretty simple, but yet difficult at the same time. Now, I believe after this point, once you clear all the ads out, you will move on to the next phase, which will be the Oracle phase. Now, all you have to do is honestly just divide yourselves up into left or right. So you'll have three people on the left, three people on the right, really. Or you can have two right, two left, two center, usually behind that pillar, to help take out the hidden ones. So as you saw there, just clearing out the ritual fanatics. So you see here, I believe at this point we had two people down, which wasn't a problem because all it is you just killing ads, which isn't that hard. So and there, who I think that was Nick. Or no, that may have been. So now, as you can see, we cleared that area. You'll get your loot. which at this point I'm switching to Sunzinger, which I believe was more effective at this point. Or it really wasn't, because there was no need to, since it's not the old raid where you can honestly just not do a challenge. So right now, the oracles, that is showing you where the oracles will spawn. You have these three, you have that one, the other two are going to be behind a right column and behind a right, the lower portion of the right side, behind a smaller column. Now, right now, all you have to do is make sure you have good team communication. If you see one, yell back left, back right, hitting left, hitting right, such as, and as you see, three shotgun shots will take down an oracle. If you have an exotic sword like Dark Drinker or Raise Lighter, that also does the trick. And you saw I got marked because we missed one. Now, also key, if you miss one, you will be marked for negation. So when the Templar goes for the ritual negation, whoever is still marked will die. So right there, if everyone had still been marked, you would have died. Now you saw KV Soup die because he was low on health. Wasn't his fault, but you can honestly still just, as like I said, good team communication. I'm so sorry, it's really late at night when I'm recording this, but good team communication. You want to yell center, back right, mid left, back left, such forth. No one was getting it, so I think someone was like, okay, I got it. And I believe, I don't know what I was doing. Oh yes, so a few people had died. We got marked by the oracles, and we chose to wipe. So you don't have to worry about that. If you wipe, you wipe. It's not gonna, there's no timing. Not like with the Death Singer challenge where you had a time frame to complete it to get your exotic loot. The first time I did the challenge, I completed it in 2 minutes and 9 seconds. We were 9 seconds short on it. And then the next time I did it was a minute and 59 seconds, which was hilarious because we were a second under, which was really good because I got the record book for it. So, like I said, destroy the oracle. So I always choose to go left because I have Talalik, or I run something that can take out things at a range, so I know I can hit multiple targets at different locations. So I chose to hide here because I thought it would be a safe point for me to hit that hidden one. I can still hit center, I can still hit the mid left one, so it's not really a problem. If you want, you can fast forward to the Templar section, which would be in a few minutes. But if you want to watch the whole thing, feel free. I think I'll probably take a break for a second from talking because I explained it thoroughly. Don't miss an oracle or you'll be marked for negation. You have to use the pool. You can only use the pool 3 times, and there are 4 rounds of oracles, so good communication is key. Yet again, you want to make sure that you're killing adds as fast as possible, so that way you don't get caught with your pants down when trying to kill an oracle and you have to worry about 3 different ads. And again, yet I said we missed one, so don't miss one, or you gotta clean yourself and risk, and it resets every time you miss one. So even if you're at the last one, if you missed one, you gotta redo the 4. So don't miss one, please. It takes a little off of stress off your teammates. Because I know sometimes you get into raids, or if you like, you find a random raid team, and they're just like, "Oh, come on, what are you doing? Oh, you're being such a fag right now." It takes a lot of stress off. Just be very mindful. Try not to die as much, because it takes a load off your teammates when they don't have to worry about clearing out extra adds or oracles because you died. So I'm gonna leave it right here. You guys can skip ahead if you want. I'll probably shorten it up to where we actually completed it, so that way you don't just see me dying and it doesn't look right. I'm just playing around, okay? Okay, now, like I said, right now I'm just gonna talk to you guys, so that way, because I skipped to a part of it where we actually completed it, so this run is going to be the completed run. So at that point, I got into a spot where I can see most of them, but like I said, key communication, blah, 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 all that, yak, yak, not going to repeat myself like for the 80th time. So I hope you guys are enjoying the more recent gameplays, such as the God of War story that I'm going to be doing a playthrough for, because I just enjoy that game. I'll probably do more Destiny, so that way I'll do the weekly raids and challenges every week from now on. So next week when they release Oryx, oh god, I will try my hardest. I will probably release that part in segments, because that is going to be a lot of editing, a lot of talking, and a lot of explaining to do for each challenge. Because I'm almost certain they're going to have a challenge for each segment, and Oryx was the first raid to introduce the three boss segment portion of it, and Vossix or Wrath of the Machine took hold after that. So, and I'm pretty sure 90% of y'all have already run through both those raids. Listen, leave me alone. Every time I get to try and do it, everyone bails out, so I get stuck with my pants now. Alright? But, anywho, so, like I said, I hope you guys are enjoying so far the video so far. I put a lot of work into the video. Like, you don't understand how late it is right now for me to be up talking, and I have to be in work at like 10. So I hope you guys do appreciate it at least, in the very least. Like I said, the God of War, I will be probably doing some more For Honor soon. I've just been taking a break from For Honor for a while because it's gotten to the point where, you know, people are just being kind of rude in that game, you know. So, you know, it's good to take a break from the game. I haven't played really Destiny. I played Destiny, at like, probably like, I mentioned this in like a hella previous video. At the time of me working two jobs, which was probably like, it was technically last year, but probably about like 5-6 months ago, I really didn't have a lot of time to play Destiny. I would usually be up at like 6, up and out the house by 6 o'clock, and be working from about 8 o'clock in the morning to about, usually wouldn't get in back in the house until probably about 10:30, 11 at night some nights. And it was very tiring because I didn't have time, a lot of time, to record games. And then the weekends I did, I worked a secondary job at GameStop. So I didn't really have a lot of time to record videos for you guys, or let alone edit and upload, because some nights, 90% of the nights, I'd be honestly drained of just everything, and I wouldn't want to even turn on my PlayStation, even to watch a YouTube. So now I just, right now I'm just in the middle of finding a new job and trying to get my life together. I'm working on a few big things. One is getting a place of my own. For those of you who don't know, I probably said I'm living with my grandparents currently, and they're just, I think at a point in the raid, like earlier in the raid, my grandmother comes in and asks me if I ate, and I have to tell her, like, yeah, I ate, I mean, all that good stuff, and she's a sweetheart, and I just appreciate her so much. Her and my grandfather are both awesome people. Love your grandparents, love your parents. Well, I know sometimes it's hard, trust me, I know what it's like, but you try your hardest. Sometimes they just don't understand, and that's fine. You just gotta, what's the phrase, love with a stick, I guess. I mean, you love them at a distance. That's the long short of it. You love them at a distance, even though you may not want to talk to them, or like you don't really, even though they try and make you the bad guy, you try your hardest just not to just make yourself look like the bad guy, because not everyone will agree with them. But okay, as you can see here, we did complete the oracles, you know, no problem for real. So now at this point I am going to cut to a portion of the raid where we are doing the Templar challenge. And now the Templar challenge is probably the hardest part of this fucking raid, only due to the fact that you have multiple things to handle at once. Now, person's going to pick up the relic. Same thing with the oracles. You're going to monitor for the oracles. You're going to say make left. Now what you're going to want to do is what we kept doing is waiting after 4, because then he would take a lot of time to summon them again. So we would go after 4. You can technically go after 2. Now don't do what I did. Have someone let them know when they're about to take the shield down, because when he takes the shield down, it activates the barrier. And if you're out of it, like you're in the air or you have a relic, you're going to be outside and you're going to take extra damage. Now what we decided to do here, we decided to run a weapons light bubble, and we unloaded everything into the Templar. Now, as you can see there, they put up a bubble for the relic holder, so that way he doesn't have to use it. Now, Cosmic at this point was the relic holder, and if you have Sleeper Simulate, that is a very good weapon to use in this raid. It is the one most recommended one. Now, what I was running was Devil's Dawn, which is a powerful sniper in general, and Gjallarhorn, because they do massive amount of damage. We had Weapons of Light, as you can see. You want to go for those good crits, try and do as much damage as possible. As you can see, I was trying to hurry up and get my heavy ammo synth, because we lost a man, and I was like, oh, come on, we really need to do this. So, Templar's challenge is, you want to make sure you kill the red oracles as fast as possible, allowing the relic holder to get his supercharge. He fires that supercharge, make sure you're not in the air. When you do it, break out of that bubble as fast as possible, and you're going to run from that side to the left side where I previously was looking over at the one red oracle. And that's just all he's going to go back and forth. The way we did it is had our relic holder go behind us, behind those pillars, and jump on, so that way he didn't have to stand there the whole time. Now, it is also good to note that this did take us some time, so I did cut to a clip where we hadn't kept failing. Now, this is just us going through the Gordon's Labyrinth. Gordon's Labyrinth is probably the second easiest part. Now, I'm going to reiterate, because I don't have to dust over this. You can just follow us, follow my path, and you'll get out as quickly as possible. Just be mindful of the Gordon, says there are now 11, as opposed to the fewer number that were in there before. So remember, Templar's challenge is the hardest. That will probably take you a good 20 odd minutes on. I am sorry, that is probably the gooder portion of this, the longer portion of this this raid. Like I said, so once the relic holder has the relic, make sure you're calling out which side the red oracles are on. You want to destroy them as fast as possible, or allowing the relic holder to destroy them, so that way he can build the super. Now once you have that, yet again, have your relic holder say 3, 2, 1, we're firing, to let you guys know to stay put where you are or be behind cover. When you do that, so you can break out of your bubble and not take extra damage. So once you do that, your relic holder is going to jump from platform, from teleportation ring to teleportation ring, preventing the Templar to teleport, or you will fail the challenge and not get your good loot. So stop him from teleporting, you get your exotic. And you, the way you, like I said, the way you do that is jumping on those rings. They turn white, put your bubbles up, put your shield up if you are the relic holder, and make sure you don't die. Everyone else, the way we did it, we weren't worried about the ads, because the ads have no aim. So what we did was have everyone else who had a heavy weapon, such as Sleeper, and it is all with me, Gjallarhorn, you have run that, and you do as much DPS as possible. If you have a weapon bubble, you run it, because it helps with damage, and you can clear it faster. So right now, as you can see, the next portion is the Gordon's Labyrinth, which is very self-explanatory, as you just saw there. Just don't get caught, and you'll make it out alive. Now there is also a secret cave in here, a secret chest in here as well. Instead of going to the left, you see me going right to that red light. There is going to be a Gorgon in there. There's going to be another hidden room. You go in there, get another chest, And I think that's the one part that everyone liked about World of Glass. They had multiple chests in it. They did take out the exotic chest, though. The chest that was primarily giving out a lot of exotic at the time in year one. So, you will also take that pass if you want to get the chest. You don't have to. Like I said, it's not mandatory. So right now, I believe this is the one where we got out, because we're playing around. Usually what me and Cosmic do when we run through this, we have a race to see who can get out the fastest, and we didn't have to do that. Sometimes the Gorgons would just look at you. Cosmic went right for whatever reason, I don't know why, even though me and him were like the last ones out that run. Oh no, that we got caught apparently. But anyhow, you're gonna go up there if you want. You'll see it in the next one if it works. But yeah, this raid should take you no more than a good hour, about 5 minutes, not even, for the gate to open. Approximately like 15 to 20 minutes doing the oracles. Another probably 15 to 20 doing the Templar challenge for this week. Probably it should no longer take you, honestly, more than like 7 to 10 minutes to go through the Gorgon's Labyrinth and the jumping puzzle, which is the next smaller portion of this raid. Should no longer take you more than that. And then Atheon's challenge shouldn't take you more than about 20 minutes if you wanna one phase it. And I'll explain that once we get there, if we can stop getting caught. But right now I'm just showing, going to more channel related things. I do hope you guys are enjoying the content, though. Like I said before, I do try my hardest to upload as frequently as possible, even though it may be like once or twice a week, or maybe even some weeks where I upload every day. Yeah, I'm trying to at least have a somewhat steady flow of content on the channel. And it's okay to take a break, but sometimes taking a break can mean the end of the world for you. So here we decided to, like, you know what's attracting them. If you don't want to attract the Gorgons, try and stay away from sprinting or double jumping. So that flying, there you saw, I'm stuck. And Grandeur, who is the newer raid, the raid team that we finished with. But yeah, so, you know, like I said, you don't want to get caught as many times as we did, because we were playing a bit, and we're just making dumb mistakes, you know. Everyone makes dumb mistakes. The Gorgon, there's no timing for this, and you don't have to beat this raid within a certain time, honestly. But realistically, even with challenges and all, it should no longer take you more than an hour and probably approximately 20 minutes to do this raid, even though I shortened mine to 55, because you're going to make mistakes in this raid. That is hands down. Unless you have run this raid 100 times with the challenges, there is no way that you're not going to make a mistake with a new set of people, which some people in our group hadn't even done the Ball of Glass raid from year one, which is fine. No one plays this game as its religion, and people do play this game as their religion. But it's okay, because, you know, different strokes, different folks, all that good stuff. But, should probably lay my head down at least for a second while I get out of here. So at this portion, we're just like, oh my god. The Gorgons are just sitting there, just kind of like eyeing us. I'm sitting there trying to think whether or not I want to run ramp. But it's, we decided that, it's okay, because, it's, like I said, it took me a hell of a long time to get the 400. I got lucky, and Iron Banner was out. And, I got lucky that Iron Banner was out, and I got my 400 stuff and it was very long and tedious. Like, I was probably stuck on 390 for like a good few months, and then 399 for like another month and a half. So what you may want to know about the jumping puzzle is that down there it was a spot where you could jump on it, and then just honestly kind of glide your way to there. Now, as you saw, they went from the second platform and jumped all the way across, which is fine. You can do it like that. But or you can try and solve the jumping puzzle. As is, I revived him not knowing he was gonna fall. He asked me who pushed me. And I was like, oh man, I'm so sorry that you. I'm like, all right, no, just you guys, just respond. So I decided at this point to, I told him we were gonna make it together because he had a sword. He wanted to, he's a Titan. So Titans can't really fly that well. I think at this point I was waiting for the puzzle to reset, though. I was looking down the whole time because I wanted to know where the next one was going to be. I think this time I was trying to actually solve the puzzle. Or, I think I may have jumped up. Yeah, no, I jumped up the third one and timed my burst so that way I wouldn't kill myself and I landed right there. And so if you are a Warlock or a Titan, there is a, small legs that you can knock yourself off of, and I would recommend that you switch to a focus control or jump control to get around it. Like right here is where it would happen. You know, I was afraid he was gonna fall again, so I was like, okay. I was trying to look at it, and he did it like that. I was like, okay, I'm pretty sure I can do that. I was trying to get around it. I was trying to inch my way around and I slipped. And there was no going back. And as you may see, some people did the raid wall, such as Cosmic. He got the helmet for his Titan and used his ornaments to get the helmet. So I think, you know what? I think like right now I'll probably like speed it up so that way you don't have to watch the entire thing of me failing like two more times. Give me a second. Right, guys, now once you get past the jumping puzzle portion, you're gonna wanna, now this is where it kind of gets tricky, and where you kind of can skip the video, you don't have to, but it's all up to you. What you're gonna do is kill the gatekeeper so that way you can start to access the time plates. Now, this is gonna be the tricky part. This is where it can get to Atheon's challenge. What you're gonna wanna do is know which sides are which. So when Atheon comes, you're going to teleport to either Mars or Venus. Now, it is Mars, right, Venus, right, Mars, left. So, when you get teleported, your teammates are going to go to those plates and stand on them and kill the supplicants. Make sure not to use a shotgun on them or they will explode in your face and kill you. You always need to have a person on the plate at all time. So this is going to be the key part. You don't want to cleared it. So now what we're doing is opening these gates, and what happens is you're gonna go in there, kill the gatekeeper that is in there, grab the relic, and come out. Same thing for the right side. And once you have both relics, there's going to be a third one that appears in the middle up top, as you can see up there. And what you're going to do is defend off the from the minotaurs. Same thing as the very beginning. You don't want them on, or they will fuck up everything for you and slow your progression. Now, as you can see here, I was running a scout rifle. Like I said here, you don't want them to get there because it messes up and takes longer. We kind of did take a little bit longer than we needed to, and we're also trying to get the Atheon challenge down pat so everyone could just seamlessly do it. So we did wipe like once or twice, and we kind of got annoyed, so we kind of just rushed through it, and I kind of cut out the part with about it. Explaining it is very simple. There's not much to do, not much to memorize. So what we did was, like I said, awaken the glass throne, which was grabbing all the relics, whether it was the one center, the one from Mars, and the one from Venus. Now, this is the Atheon challenge. Now, the Atheon challenge is very complicated. Not as complicated, but it is pretty easy to achieve. Now, what you're going to want to do is, let's just say if everyone doesn't have sleepers anyway, like I didn't have, what you want to do is, if that person gets teleported, have them grab the relic, because it makes it a lot easier on the DPS portion once you get the Atheon. Now, what we did was, is that Atheon opened the time portal. Now, as you can see, they got teleported to, I believe, Mars. They got teleported to Mars, so we stand on that right, on that left plate. Now, as soon as the other, if one person is still standing, you, the other two will jump in there and help out. Now, but I think that time whoever was on the plate died, so we have to wipe. So, the Atheon challenge is, once you get teleported, one person grabs the relic, the first two people will kill two oracles. That's it. Everybody has to kill one oracle every run. If you do it this in one run, you only gotta worry about killing them all at once. But when that happens, whoever is standing on that plate, make sure you're trying to clear out as many supplicants as possible to make it easier on everyone who's coming out marked by the void, because sometimes they might not be able to see. Now, what this does is, when you get teleported in, make sure you kill your one. Like, if you have the first one, kill the first one. If you have the second one, kill the second one. Use your heavy, use your special. So right here, I grabbed the relic because I don't have sleeper. So what I did was, they throw grenades down there. I used my heavy, which is my R2 or R1, depending on how you play. And I clear out those adds. Now, see how they came in? They're waiting for their oracles. I burst cleansed, so that way I didn't use it. So that way, once everyone got theirs, I was making sure. He came in, he came and killed his. I killed mine. We cleansed and got out of there. Now, but what you want to do is have the meetup spot be from the middle. You want to make sure you're not using rockets, or you will kill yourself in your bubble. Now, everyone did have sleeper. Make sure he does not use any grenades, or he will move. And like there, he just was moving. But we did manage to do this in one run, which was exciting because it made it a lot easier. As you can see here, we did the challenge mode correctly. So I got Atheon's Epilogue, the in-depth version, and I also got the legendary Fate Burner, which was really cool. I did hope you guys did enjoy my video.
I didn't say anything.
The Walter Glass Templar and Atheon challenge. So always remember, for the Templar challenge, call out your oracles, make sure your relic holder kills them, everyone else should worry about DPS.
That's what it was.
And your really cooler should take the outside route going behind the pillars towards you guys. So that way he times it right. He only has to stand on the plate for about 1 second. Okay? Atheon's challenge, everyone has to kill one oracle per run. So if you do it in 3 runs, everyone has to kill an oracle 3 times. Now that's not saying you already clear 3 oracles in here, he clears 3 oracles in there. No, everyone has to kill 1 oracle each run. Or else you will fail the challenge. To do, I will reiterate both. Templar, stop him from teleporting by hitting those rings. You stand on them for about a good second. If you do it the way we did it, you don't have to, but it decreases the likelihood of you having to wipe. So, like I said, I hope you guys did enjoy today's video. It took me so long to make. Like, I am hella tired right now. But I hope you guys do appreciate it. I appreciate you guys. Please leave a like, comment, subscribe, all that good stuff. I will do this again next week for Oryx. And that's going to be probably a 3-part. Because that's going to be a lot of talking. That's going to be at least like a good 2 hours worth of talking. And I don't feel like talking that long. I'm going to be talking for about like 50-something minutes. And I am like drained. So, like I said, hope you guys enjoy. Please leave a like, comment, subscribe, all that good stuff. And I'll see you guys in the next one. Peace.